हाँ, तो काफी सारी चीजें करती है आरती. प्लीज डोंट गो ऑन हर लुक्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ शी यू नो वेरी प्रिटी एंड पेटीट एंड बट शी इज गॉट द अमाउंट ऑफ एनर्जी शी हैज. ओ माय गॉड. एंड आई वी एक्सपीरियंस दिस पर्सनली. पूना चैप्टर हैड ऑर्गेनाइज दिस सेशन एंड बिलीव मी इफ यू गाइज आर अवेयर ऑफ द एनसीसीआई ऑडिटोरियम The entire auditorium was dancing, sitting in their chairs. Wow, that was a scene, man. So, Aarti, thank you so much for coming up with this mission and wanting to share it under the NHRD platform. Thank you. Not, jara kuch nahi bolunga. I hand this over to you, ladies and gentlemen. Please make the most of her expertise and whatever queries and doubts you have, please ask her and. All the best to you, Aarti, and to your team
for having the
PCOS mission. Yeah.
Thank you
so much. Goodbye.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Aman sir, for such beautiful words and always encouraging me. Good evening, ladies and few gentlemen that I see. A big round of applause to all the men who have come for this webinar to support women of their house or to understand about this. Few ground rules. So I will not be able to hear you or see you, but there is a Q&A section. If you guys can see the Q&A section, that's where you can write whenever I'll tell you to write something, or the last 15 minutes will be all about question and answers. So I'm going to make sure that through my presentation, I answer all the doubts and queries that you are carrying about hormonal imbalance and PCOS. In case some of the questions are not answered, wait for the last 15 minutes where we can chat on the Q&A. If you can hear me, please show a thumbs up on Q&A and write a yes so that I know that you guys are with me and we can start my presentation. Great, Dipali. Thank you for being quick. Thank you, Swati, Chami. Lovely. Second thing, I do not want you to make notes. Just focus on this presentation. Be 100% available because you guys have given your 1 hour. So let's make the most of it. Keep that phone away. Put it off. There is no emergency for the next 1 hour. This is for your health. This is for your wellness. So let's begin this journey together. On that note, I'm going to share my presentation. Githika, are you able to see the deck?
Yes, it's seen.
Great, thank you. All right, so Aman sir has been very kind to already speak about me, so I'm not going to take much time. Just want you to let you all know that in this journey of folk fitness, I made a women community, and working myself in corporate and also with this community, I got to understand the biggest pain area. And when we did a survey and tried to understand, the biggest pain area of women was PCOS. And that's where my journey of creating a PCOS-free India began. Now, I came across a lot of stories in this journey, but there are two peculiar stories of two women who are working women, and I would like to share that with you. The first one is of Shruti. She's 22 years old now, but her life changed when she was 14 and she got her first period. And she had a lot of pain, a lot of flow. And when she went to her mother and told about her pain, she was told that it's normal. It's normal for a woman to get pain. She missed those 5 days of her school every year. She missed those 5 days of college every year. It was only after gaining 18 excess kilos and getting those acnes is when she went to the gynec and she was diagnosed with PCOS. And this is only because of lack of awareness and the feeling that being in pain in periods, it's normal. I want all of you to know that it's common, but it is not normal. Then about Rhea. She's 27 years old now. She was trying to conceive for the last 2 years. With fertility treatment, she has a 3-year-old child now. However, her PCOS has come back. And this is a classic example when we try and do a band-aid solution. She's always feeling fatigued and she somehow blames the work balance, the work-home relationship that she has, and she blames it for it. But this is because of all the band-aid solutions that we've tried to do and not really nail down what exactly is the root cause of our PCOS, and we try to reverse it. We ignore the symptoms that we get. And the reason of sharing these two stories with all of you ladies is because we might have some Shruti or Riya around you or within us. And these are the symptoms that any of you have should not be ignored. Unwanted excess weight gain. We carry a lot of fat around our belly and we say that baki sab to theek hai, but ye belly fat jo hai na, ye chala jaye. We don't realize how we are suffocating our ovaries, not letting the ovaries breathe at all. The acne. You know, I always say that our skin is the mirror to our internal system. And if you're getting acne, which are painful and big, we cannot ignore it. And the worst would be to go for a skin treatment or try and apply those creams because it's just doing a superficial treatment. But there's a root cause and we'll get to it within a while. Irregular or missed periods. You know, some of us always congratulate a woman who misses periods and say, "Yaar, tu kitni lucky hai, teko ek do mahine nahi aate, to wo jhanjat chala gaya." But we do not realize that regular periods means our body is working in rhythm, that every single organ in our body is functioning the way it should. So even if we have delayed periods or missed periods, it's a sign that our body is giving us. Which leads to irritability, mild depression, to severe depression. And sometimes it's just unknown. Why? Because we are not understanding our issue. How would we let others know about it? We don't feel like going out. We do self-doubts. Even at work, we don't want to take that promotion which is coming for us. We are hiding. We are not having an intimate relationship with our partner. And we don't know why. All that irritation sometimes even comes out on our kids. One of the major root cause and also a symptom of PCOS is difficulty in conceiving. You know, something which is so naturally given to us as women has become so unnatural now. There used to be only 3 IVF centers in Pune. Now we have 246 IVF centers. And that just speaks about how it's becoming difficult for us to conceive. And of course, those unwanted hair growth that we get on our cheeks, on our chin, on our chest, which is called hirsutism, which happens because of hormonal imbalance due to the male hormones increasing in our body. So all of these are the symptoms where our body is indicating that, boss, it's time for you to take your health in your hand. Now, what is PCOS? I am not going to speak in a very scientific way, but in a very, very simple language. Polycystic ovarian syndrome. Poly means many. Cystic means cyst looking like. Ovarian means inside the ovary. And syndrome means a constellation of syndrome that we just saw. All these symptoms may lead towards PCOS or PCOD. Now, there's always this question that comes across as, what is the difference between PCOD and PCOS? PCOD is the only hormonal imbalance disorder, wherein PCOS, along with hormonal imbalance, it's also an endocrine disorder, which means it's reached your organs also. PCOD is a little easier to reverse, while PCOS takes a little more time to reverse. Now, for us to understand and take care of our ovaries, it's important for us to understand our reproductive system quickly. That's the fallopian tube. Those are our ovaries, our uterus, and our vagina. Now, our ovaries contain lifetime supply of eggs. And these eggs are immature and they are stored in follicles, right? Now, what happens in a normal situation when our body is working the way it's supposed to work? A free egg is released every month in the fallopian tube and the egg gets either fertilized and we get pregnant, or the egg is not fertilized and we should, ladies, get a menstrual cycle every single month. These are the only two things which are possible in our body, and that's what it should happen. Now, what happens in the case of PCOS? Do you see on the right side these pearl looking like cysts over our ovaries? And this is our normal ovary. Now, these immature follicles, they do not mature and they remain as cysts on our ovaries. and they keep growing every month. And this happens due to the hormonal imbalance in our body. You know, from the hypothalamus, our hormones are released. It goes to the pituitary gland. From pituitary gland, our hormones get released. They come to our ovaries. Our ovaries release some more hormones, and that's the whole system. But in a simple language, if the men and the women hormones in our body, they are not in harmony, and male hormones are more in our body, that's when PCOS condition takes place in our body. Now, you must be wondering as to how many women, is it rare, is it common? You will be surprised to know that one in every five women today, which is of childbearing age, is suffering from PCOS. From the age of 16 to the age of 45, 50, there are women who are suffering from PCOS. Now, let me bring you back to this room today. I hope you all remember, you all filled the PCOS survey, just a self-assessment form. We have more than 50% women in this room today who have some of the problems with their periods. It's either 8 or fewer periods. You have either scanty bleeding, or we have visited a fertility specialist. Let's talk about skin and hair problems like excess facial hair or dark or discolored patches on our skin. More than 70% today who have attended this webinar have either skin or hair problems. And around 55% of us today either have excess weight gain, which is unexplainable, or we get lack of concentration while we are working, or uncontrollable hunger, or we get mood swings which are not explainable. We either get upset on our family, or we just snap at our boss, because even we don't know what's happening within our body. So the first thing, ladies, is to tell ourselves, it's all right. I am not this weird person, or I'm not the person who gets mood swings, but it's something in our body, and we need to just, it's a disorder, and we need to get it in order. The minute we get our system in order, all these symptoms will just disappear from our body. Now, while I was, you know, talking to so many women, and we did the surveys and through the webinars, I actually realized that we are not just dealing with the problem of PCOS. So what are the other problems that we're dealing with, which comes with PCOS? It's the lack of awareness. I wish Shruti and Riya were aware that what could have happened in their body just by that missed period, or just by those 2 or 3 acnes. But today, people are not talking about PCOS as much. You know, I'm so glad that some of the gentlemen are attending this webinar today and they are listening to it. And I hope they become a support system to their family, because which is very required. But today, if a 16-year-old complains about pain, she's being told it's normal. If she complains about acne, it's being told it's normal. If a working woman is lethargic or fatigued, the family says it's those 5 days of her day. It's not true. It's something that we are dealing with within our body, which is not as popular as diabetes or cancer today, but it is also a very serious problem. Then comes acceptance. And this is within the woman. For her to accept that, yes, I have a disorder, I have something that I need to rectify, and I need to take my health in my hand. We are not ready to accept. We ignore all the time. Then comes the willingness to accept and put our health as priority. You know, we women love to put everything else in priority, our husbands, our family, our kids, then comes work, but we are always least in the priority. And then, of course, lack of family support. When I was talking to all these women, I realized that because they are not aware and willing to accept, they are not able to talk to their family, and they're not getting the required support. Now, before I proceed ahead, I have 2 questions for all of you, which I would want you all to answer. All right. So I am seeing the Q&A, and my question here is, are you courageous enough to take the step of changing your lifestyle? Are you courageous enough to say that, yes, I'm going to change my lifestyle? And are you committing to give time to yourself? And I want a hell yes. I want to see all these beautiful women who are attending today and the gentlemen, are you courageous enough to support your family women? So I really want to see that yes, because I have 125 of you listening to me today. Thank you. Thank you, Nandini. Thank you, Shruti. Wow. If you're not willing to commit your time and if you're not courageous to take those lifestyle changes, then this webinar is a waste of time. Everything that I'm going to speak from here on is going to be about how can you change your lifestyle and reverse this. Thank you, Preena. Yes, it's high time now. I'm so glad to hear that. Lovely. So all of you are saying a hell yes to me. Excellent. Thank you, Urvashi. Wow, Saurabh. Thank you. A gentleman saying a yes. I'm so happy for your family, women of your family. Thank you, Kirtika. And are you committed to give time to yourself? No excuses of work or shifts. Wonderful. I am so glad to hear that. Is my screen visible, Gitika?
Yes, it's visible.
Thank you. Wonderful. So now that all of you have given me a hell yes, we can proceed. I want all your attention now. So once I understood this problem, I wanted to understand that, all right, you know, acne, there is hair loss, we have weight gain, and women are somehow okay to live with it or do a superficial treatment by going to a skincare specialist or doing a laser or trying different exercise methods and blaming either the workout or the gym or their office, basically finding excuses. But we need to understand, ladies, that PCOS is not just about these symptoms or about looking in a particular way. What does this PCOS actually lead to? Fatigue. How many of you here have a 8-hour sleep but also get up tired? You're all the time feeling lack of concentration. You're feeling that fatigue in your body. I have women who've come to me and said that. And of course, through this reversal program, they have felt the energy. But fatigue is one of the biggest causes that leads through PCOS. Sleep apnea. Do you know that India is the second sleep deprived country? And 67% of women who have PCOS have sleep apnea. Now, what is this sleep apnea? How many of you actually wake up suddenly in the night and feel breathlessness? You know, or you're frequently going to the washroom or you're changing sides, but you're always constantly not getting that sleep that you need. Type 2 diabetes. The common cause of PCOS and type 2 diabetes is insulin resistance. Now, the job of insulin is to actually make your cells get the energy, convert sugar into energy. And when it's not able to do its job properly, you get diabetes. 83% of women who have PCOS may lead to type 2 diabetes. Infertility. One in every six couple today is actually struggling from getting a child. One in every six couple. Just imagine the count. Heart diseases. Women with PCOS has 50% more chances, more risk of a heart stroke or a heart disease. Endometrial cancer. You know the ones where we say that, oh wow, you don't get periods every month. Our uterus lining is not shedding every month, which means that it is making us prone to the endometrial cancer. And we have 2.5 times more risk, more chances to get endometrial cancer than a woman without a PCOS condition. And there are so many such things that can happen to us if we do not correct our course, if we do not reverse our PCOS timely. Now, most of you would either be taking modern medicines or would be thinking, but Aarti, you know, you have these medicines. Why can't we just pop them and take care of it? I want you to really imagine someone who you know, if someone who has a medical condition like a cancer or diabetes, and if you have ever seen them having medicines and coming and telling you, hey, I could reverse my situation because of medicines. Or imagine a situation where their tablets have gone from 2 to 4 to 8 and only increasing in quantity. What are medicines? Medicines are chemicals, right? And what are you doing to your body? You're giving them more chemicals. And by this chemical, you're working on something which is unknown, your hormonal imbalance. What does birth control pills do? They mimic your periods. They don't really give you the actual periods. So this medicines can only do a superficial job in your body, like a band-aid solution. But until and unless you work on your reversal, by working on your root cause, you won't achieve the desired results. Now, a lot of women in this journey told me that, Aarti, we've tried everything, we're taking medicines, but we are not really getting the results. And that's what made me, you know, my journey began to explore, can PCOS reversal happen without medication? And if yes, how? What can be done? What should be done? And in this journey, I wanted to explore the root cause. We need to first understand the root cause and only then can we resolve it, right? So for that, ladies, I met a lot of experts from different domains, different verticals of medicine, of experts. I met a lot of gynecologists. And, you know, they told me, Aarti, the root cause of PCOS is lifestyle disorder, but it cannot be reversed. It can only be managed. So all they need to do is keep taking medicines. Now, somehow it didn't really convince me. I met a lot of nutritionists. They also said, Aarti, the root cause is lifestyle, but they have to take care of your food. If they eat a particular diet, then they can reverse their PCOS. I said, okay. Again, in isolation, I met physiologists, and being, you know, in being in the fitness industry for a decade, I have seen a lot of women coming with this prescription saying, I need to lose 10 kgs and then my PCOS will be reversed. I met yoga experts. They said there are specific asanas. If the women do that, it can help them. I met psychologists. They said it's a psychosomatic disorder, which is true, which also means that your mental well-being is very important. Everyone was speaking the truth, but they were all giving solutions in isolation, right? And I wanted to understand that, is there a holistic way? So let's explore first, guys, the root cause of PCOS. I want all your attention here right now, because until and unless you understand this, you will not be able to reverse your PCOS. So we have understood so far that unhealthy lifestyle is the root cause. But what do you mean by unhealthy lifestyle? It's so vast. Doctors tell us, aapki lifestyle achhi kar lo, sab theek ho jayega. But when you're telling me to improve my lifestyle, what exactly do you mean? So these are the root causes of PCOS, my dear ladies. 5 food related causes. There are 3 exercise related causes. There is 1 stress related cause and there is 1 sleep related cause. Let's understand this in a little depth. The food related cause. Acidity and inflammation. What kind of food are we giving to our body today? How much pesticides, insecticides are actually going in our body? Taking teas and coffees on empty stomach. How much acidity and inflammation is it causing us? The increase in male hormones. It is also caused with the kind of food that we eat, with the time of the food which we intake. Increase in the insulin resistance. The kind of packaged food that we are used to today causes this symptom. Lack of micronutrients. Unfortunately, the kind of food that we intake today just misses all the vitamins, all the minerals, and of course the toxicity, which I'm going to talk in detail a little later. But the kind of utensils and the kind of equipments we have in our kitchen, I am sure no one of you would have ever paid attention into what we are cooking. Are these utensils causing any kind of harm to our body? And yes, the answer is yes, they are. And we'll talk about it in detail. But these are the 5 food related causes that we must work for reversing our PCOS. Exercises, the sedentary lifestyle. What do you mean by that? You know, our cells, we have 1 trillion cells in our body. And all of them have an equipment within them to understand the kind of movement you do in a day. Are you moving enough? Are you moving enough to be healthy? Lack of muscle strengthening. How many of you are really putting attention to your muscles, doing the right kind of exercise? Some of you are only walking. Some of you are only jogging. Are we giving the right kind of cardiovascular and also the kind of flexibility and the kind of muscle strengthening that our body needs? And all that excess fat that we carry above our ovaries, making it suffocating, making it difficult for our ovaries to breathe. Where is the origin of our PCOS? For us to reverse our PCOS, we need to keep our ovaries healthy. Not only for our PCOS, but as women, it's a very, very important organ for us to keep healthy. Stress. A very common word, we use it very casually so many times. Oh, today I'm feeling very stressed. The stress hormones, how do they impact PCOS, ladies? The stress hormones, cortisol and DHEAS, they create a havoc in your hormonal imbalance. So every time you're taking stress, you must realize what you're doing to your body. Your mind and your body are deeply connected. So, and just think about it. Every time you take stress, is there any chronic pain that you feel? A little tingling pain in your shoulder, a little pain in your lower back. Headache gets aggravated. All of this, how does this happen? Because your mind and your body are connected. Sleep, something that we have taken so casually. And here I'm not talking about the quantity of sleep. It's not the 8 hours, 9 hours that we sleep, but it is the quality that we must take care about. So these are all the causes that one must work. And a lot of women told that, you know, I'm trying solutions in isolation and they are not giving results, because holistic solution needs to be a blend of all. All of these causes have to be reversed for us to have reversal. And that's when, ladies, we got an expert panel, because I really wanted to ensure that the solution is an integration of all. And that's why we have medical experts. We have our Ayurvedic experts on board. We have our mind experts who have done their master practitioner of NLP. We have our MBBS, because it's a medical disorder. We have our gynecologist and MBBS on board. And all of them together have 150 years of experience together. They were all working on PCOS in isolation. But when they all came together, we could create something which is magical and which can guarantee reversal. And when they all came together, now again, pay a lot of attention, because this slide is very, very important. We have come up with a well-researched, scientifically proven, and this is followed by thousands of women, ladies, the 5 pillars which will get you freedom from PCOS. With us or on your own. When you take this journey of reversal, these are the 5 pillars that all of you must work on. So what are these 5 pillars? Eat right. Now, when I say eat right, what do I mean? I do not mean follow a diet, because diets restrict you. We must know that we are what we eat. Every cell in our body talks to the food that has come in within us. So it's very, very important to understand this. The concept of mithara, which means eating in moderation, not just overstuffing us, but to listening to our hunger and not to our tongue. Ritucharya, which means eating seasonal and in discipline. You know, we must embrace our local food. We must embrace our seasonal fruit, and not just like this month is not a month of apple. How many of us are getting these Kentucky apples and Australian apples and really enjoying that? But do you know what is the shelf life of these apples? They are not even local. They are not even seasonal. So things like that has to be worked on in the eat right pillar. Move more. And I'm not talking about the 45 minutes of exercise that we all are aware of. But I'm talking about moving your cells more, which means for every hour, how many times are you getting up? How many times are you opening the door? How many times are you taking that glass of water by getting up, how many times are you standing and not just sitting? So it's a very, our cells, like I told, play a very important role, and they understand your movement, and your life reduces if you have a sedentary lifestyle. Very, very important pillar. Now, sleep better. Now, we must understand the importance and significance of this pillar. If you're not sleeping well, you're not giving an opportunity for your organs to get the desired rest, your brain to develop. It is still developing. Your learning ability is still there. And every time you get quality sleep, you're resetting the button and making them all energized for the next day. So when we brag about, hey, I was watching Netflix till, you know, 4 in the morning and I just caught up 3 hours, then I just took up I grabbed coffee for my lunch. These are not right things for your body, and they will affect, and they are affecting your system. They are getting it in this order that we spoke about. So very important pillar, sleep. Breathe in awareness. Now, it's so fascinating. The first thing we do when we come in this, on this earth, is breathe. And the first thing that goes away when we die, you know, the last thing that goes away when we die is breath. Even right now, all of us here are doing shallow breathing. How many of you are actually being with your breath throughout the day, even for 5 minutes? And what does breathe awareness do? It's prana. It's the energy that every organ of our body needs. And if you're not being with your prana, if you're not giving that oxygen to your organs, how are they going to perform to their optimal level? And mind-free. We all talk about being mindful, but what about releasing those stress? For actually, we've created these boundaries around us. Who are we? What is my purpose? My emotions. It's all right to have emotions. It's excellent to have emotions. But are you aware of your emotions? Are you aware when to utilize those emotions? So these are the 5 fundamental pillars that we work on, and you all must work on to do the reversal of your PCOS and have a healthy lifestyle. Now, quickly talking about the observation that I had for working women, these are the 5 pillars that they need. They want the solution which is time efficient. It has to be convenient. Please make it easy for me to follow, Aarti. Don't give me something tough. Of course, it has to be fun. Do not make it monotonous for me. And are you going to keep me motivated? Because today when I'm listening to you, I'm all charged up. I'm like, hell yes, I'm going to take charge of my life. Come tomorrow morning, I'll have the same cup of coffee, the same calls, the same work. So how am I going to be engaged on a daily basis? So guys, I'm going to quickly tell you about the solution I have created through my enterprise. But that's not the motive of this webinar. So I'm not going to put a lot of time on that. But if anyone wants to know about our solution in detail, of course, you can make a call to us and we can discuss. But ours is a 100% online solution. And it's a must for a family member to become a support partner. So we start with a personalized medical consultation with our doctors to check your reports and tell you that, yes, what is the condition and what needs to be reversed. We have daily live sessions on holistic wellness, which is great fun for women to come together for that 1 hour and enjoy the sessions together. We do folk fitness sessions. We do HIIT sessions for your cardiovascular. And we also have specific medical yoga asanas for your pelvic region, which helps you in the reversal. None of the women ever miss the sessions, but you have an important meeting, or if you have a long day and if you miss a session, then the recorded session are available on a click of a button for you to get the recorded sessions. We do expert talks every weekend on all the 5 pillars and actually embrace you with the knowledge so that you can be independent and take charge of your life. We do not believe in diets. You have heard of keto diets, Dixit diet, and I'm not against diet, but I just feel that I do not want anyone to be restricted. You can only eat this much and only at this time. No, we believe in educating what's good for your body, and then you take the decision as to what should go in the body because your food communicates with your cells. We provide you with yummy, delicious recipes that you can experiment on your own. In Mindfree, along with the expert talks, we provide you audios and questions which are self-reflectory. It's very important for you to be with yourself and answer those questions yourself and take control of your own emotions. Pre-sleep guided practice, we have Yog Nidra, which is a 20 minutes power-packed sleep track, which is mixed with vibrations, music and mantras. And it's so amazing, ladies and gentlemen, that women in our program have come with disturbed sleep, and today they boast about sleeping with quality and getting up with energy and having the time and the energy to play with their kids, work, all of that. Micro and mini movements, like I was talking about. I understand that we all are working women and we don't have the time. How can I incorporate movements while you're working? So when you're working on your laptop, what movement can you do for your leg? While on your phone, talking to a client, can you walk and talk if it's a non-video call? So we've identified 50 such opportunities to move in your life. We call them OTMs. Nobody in India talks about this, but this is the game changer for your movement. It's not just the 45 minutes of macro exercises, but the micro and mini movement introduced in your lives. And we have Freedom Partners, which are dedicated to all of you. They help you, motivate you, guide you, and are there 24/7 to answer all the queries that you can have. And of course, we have a close community of women with the same mindset. They can come and actually discuss, share all the solutioning that they have, all the questions that they have. And now, quickly, I have a takeaway on each pillar. Okay, and then I will take all your questions. So in the Eat Right pillar, if you ask me, what is the one thing, Aarti, that I can start today? So I want you all to know that, did you know that sugar kills more people than cigarette? It's true, which doesn't mean I'm telling you keep smoking. No, but I am trying to tell you that how dangerous and risky sugar is, but it is so socially acceptable that we don't even realize the kind of addiction that we have to it. So my funda that I want to give all of you today, and I want you all to pledge, is zero is hero, which means zero refined sugar from today. And I want you all to make that promise to me. I am not telling you to leave sweet. You have your sweets, but change sugar with alternatives like dates, jaggery. You can have stevia. You can have palm sugar or coconut sugar, but leave the refined sugar, guys. It's empty calories. It actually makes you more hungry. It stops your leptin hormone from making you realize that you've eaten enough, and you keep eating. Your body cannot communicate to you, and that's the reason we keep overeating. Also, sugar has 60 different names. It has no nutritional value. But the food industry is so smart that they have created 60 different names. So all your packaged food have sugar in it. And that's why we get addictive. And you know how addictive sugar is? It is equivalent to the addiction of cocaine. So I know a lot of you will say, Aarti, my coffee doesn't taste good without sugar. My tea doesn't taste good without sugar. First, leave coffee and tea. If you can't, start enjoying the taste of it without sugar. And I've given you the alternatives. Work with that. Move more. Now, do you know that 53% of Indian women are physically inactive? 53, ladies. And as I have already discussed, move enough doesn't mean exercise. So what do I want you to do? For every 60 minutes that you sit, I want you to do a 3-minute activity. Now, what can that activity be? It can be as simple as standing and sitting on your chair. It can be take a round of your office or your workplace, which is your home right now. If you have children at home, do a 3-minute quick game. You're going to make them happy. You're going to be active. But I want you all to imbibe a 3-minute rule, 60:3 rule in your life. Sleep better. As I've already told you that India is a sleep deprived country, 8 is great. What do I mean by that? I want you, just like you calendarize all your office work and your meetings, I want you to calendarize your sleep. What do I mean by that? If you sleep at 10 every day, 10 o'clock, sleep every day at 10 o'clock and wake up at the same time. If it's 11 or 11:30 or even 12, it's all right. Make sure that you're sleeping at the same time every night and waking up at the same time. You will be amazed with the changes your body will see, guys, because your brain will get accustomed to it and body and mind work together. So try this in your sleep better vertical. I want you to imbibe, calendarize your sleep. Breathe in awareness. Did you know that deep breathing detoxifies body? It brings you from subconscious to consciousness. And it's so brilliant to be with your breath. And I would love to teach you a breathing technique right now. If I can say see a quick yes, I would, in the Q&A section, if you guys can give me a thumbs up that you guys are listening and you can see my video, I would love to. Thank you, Khushi. Thank you, Neeru. Great. So are you guys with me? I want you all to be sitting in a comfortable position. Can we be in a comfortable position? Are we there? Just stay our thumbs up. Great. Now, understand this technique, guys. This technique can be done when you're feeling really anxious, when you're feeling really stressed. You can use this. You can use this technique when you are having a craving for a dessert or you want to have that sugar that we just promised we will not have. You can use this technique. You can use this technique when you wake up in the morning. It could be the first thing to do. If you're not able to sleep properly, you can even do it at that time. All right, are you there? So the first thing you'll do is you'll inhale through your nose for the count of four. Then you will hold your breath for seven counts. And you will exhale through your mouth for eight counts. I'm going to show you first and then I'll give you counts and I want you all to do it. All right? Inhale, two, three, four, and then we hold and then we release through our mouth. I want all of you to close your eyes and just follow my instructions. Okay? Inhale, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Exhale, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One more time. Inhale, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Exhale, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One last time. Inhale, two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Exhale, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Open your eyes. Please mention, how are you feeling? Are you feeling a little relaxed? Great, amazing. Yes, relaxed, Nandri, I'm so glad. So this is my giveaway for breathing. You can try 4, 7, 8. Wow, you're feeling calm. I'm so glad. Great. You can try or you can do this on my YouTube channel. I have a video of it in case you want to. If you forget, you can check that video out on the YouTube channel. Very good question, Shalaka. How many times should you do this? Four cycles. So 4, 7, 8 is one cycle. You should do four such cycles at one go. When you're just starting, do not do more than four cycles. So 4, 7, 8, 4, 7, 8, like that, four cycles make your one time. You can do it early morning and also before sleeping. My YouTube channel is My Folk Fitness. Githika, if you can just mention the YouTube channel here for them to know. All right, we are, if Aman sir and Anand sir are okay, I would like to extend the webinar by 10 minutes if everyone is there and take all the questions. So breathe in awareness. Everyone is okay with 4-7-8 technique. Mind free. Now, do you know, ladies, that a 20-second hug releases oxytocin, which is a nature's antidepressant, and it's a happy hormone. How many of y'all know about Jadoo Ki Jhappi? Chalo, so I want all of you to give a self-hug right now. Give a nice tight hug if you're home, if your child is around you. Hug your child right now and tell me what you felt. Did it give you a big smile on your face? Self-hug or hug your husband, hug your son, daughter, anyone who's around you. And share the experience, share that smile. Did you get that smile on your face? Hugging my cat, that's amazing, Gayatri. Absolutely, Ayushi, self-hug also work. It's great if you're going to hug someone else. But if there's no one around you, self-hug 100% works. Hugging a soft toy also works. You tell me, Ayushi, when you hugged yourself, did you get that smile on your face or not? Great, great, Nishit. It's a great way. And it's scientific. It releases oxytocin. See, Ayushi, you're yourself saying a yes. So it definitely works. It releases oxytocin, which are happy hormones. And again, something which we ignore, right? So anytime you're feeling irritated or stressed, I want you all to hug someone around you. But that's not my giveaway. I have something more to give. And that is, I want all of you to begin your day with gratitude journal. You know, gratitude fosters happiness, and it is not the other way around. You should not be happy and then thank someone, but just be thankful. And I want you all to start this, and trust me, give it a week's try. It's scientific. It releases dopamine in your body. It helps you with release of serotonin in your body. Also, it actually gives you a complete positive attitude as the start of the day. I want you all to do this for a week. Give it a try. I'm sure most of you might have heard about it. Maybe some of you have not heard about it. But for me, if you find this presentation valuable and if you have taken charge of your life in your hand, I want you all to try this. From tomorrow, start with just 5 things, guys. 5 things that you're grateful about. And the second day, write 6 things, 7 things, 8 things. It could be you're grateful about the sun that came in the morning. It could be about the comfort of your house. It could be about NHRD actually organizing this webinar for you. It could be anything that you feel grateful about. It could be the food on your table. It could be the birds chirping around. Whatever it is, but I want all of you to actually begin your day with gratitude. Journaling is a very powerful tool. Again, something that we ignore. So I want you all to quickly write down what are the 5 pillars and what are the key takeaways that I have given you. Quickly, what are the 5 giveaways? What are the 5 pillars and what are the 5 things you'll do in those pillars? Do we remember that? Amazing. No sugar, move more, sleep better, breathe in awareness and gratitude journal. A big round of applause to you, Ayushi. Eat right, breathe aware, moving. Great, Gayatri. OTM, Reshmi has picked up OTM, which is opportunities to move. You can create your own opportunities. Zero his hero. Wonderful, Mridul. Oh, wow. Asta, you have nailed it. Eat right, move more, sleep better, breathe aware and mind free. I'm so glad. On that note, I'm all open to take your question, guys. Before that, this is my number and Shilpa's number from NHRD. We do corporate webinars. As I told you at the start, 1 in 5 women is facing this PCOS condition. And through these webinars in your corporate, we will only be able to reach out to more women, make them more aware of the situation and make them take their health and wellness in their hands. If you would like us to do the same webinar in your corporates, you can reach out to me or you can reach out to Shilpa from NHRDN and we can organize this webinar in your corporate. I really want to thank all of you. And now I'm all open to your questions that if I have not answered through this webinar, I would take those questions now. So Ayushi, PCOS and PCOD, the one difference between the two is PCOD is only hormonal imbalance. So it has not reached your endocrine, which is your ovaries and other organs. But in PCOS, along with the hormonal imbalance, it's reached your endocrine issue also. Great, Beena, thanks for asking about toxicity. And that's what I would like to answer. You know, when we talk about food, we only talk about what's going in our body. We never talk about what kind of utensils we are using to make that food. Now, how many of you have aluminium at home? Please write a thumbs up or write three things. Aluminium. Do you have Teflon, which is non-stick? And do you... Great. And do you have plastic at home? I want to know about plastic, Teflon, which is non-stick, and about aluminium. A lot of questions are coming. Let me answer one by one. So you will have to retype it, sorry, because there are a lot of questions going above. Yeah, aluminium cooker, right? So today I want you to do this, Swati, when you go back. See if the cooker was 5 liters or 7 liters. Measure it today. You'll be amazed to see that it's become 4.5 kgs now. Where did all that aluminium go? All that aluminium has leached in your food and got into your tummy. Absolutely, Reshmi, all the non-stick material pans are absolutely toxic. They are killing all the nutrients from our body. So remember, toxicity, lack of micronutrients and inflammation. Aluminium, non-stick pans and plastic. So plastic has a chemical in it which mimics estrogen, which is a female hormone. It mimics that and that's why we get hormonal imbalance. So today I want you all to take out these three things from your kitchen. Of course, it's going to be gradual, but start this journey. And what you need to reverse it with, you can get clay pots in your house. Cast iron is very good and 100% stainless steel. Again, on my YouTube channel, I have done videos about kitchen, which can be useful for all of you. You can actually understand in detail about all the utensils that I just spoke about. No, Aarti, Surya Namaskar and waking up is not sufficient. You must work on your cardiovascular. You must work on your flexibility. Surya Namaskar is a great addition, but it cannot just be that. Yes, Christine, hirsutism can be completely removed. Now, let me talk about hirsutism. What is hirsutism? Why do we get this thick male hair on our chin, on our cheeks? And what do? We go for lasers. Laser is not the solution. What are these male hair? They are coming from androgens and testosterone, which are male hormones. Okay? Even the hair fall. These male hormones, they go and they actually sit on the follicle of our hair. And that is what is causing all the hair fall. So the minute you get your hormones in balance, you can absolutely, one, reduce more hirsutism and slowly and gradually completely eliminate hirsutism from your body. I hope that answers your question, Christine. Shalaka, there are many good 100% stainless steel. I cannot recommend any brand on this platform. But the only thing I'll tell you is they say, make sure they talk about the ingredients, the mixture of the utensil. Some of them have nickel in it. So please ensure that nickel is not a part. It's 100% stainless steel. It is a little on the expensive side, but it's worth the it's worth the investment that we do. Exactly, Preena, a classic example, you said it yourself. Every time you stop the tablet, you get your acne back because the medicine is not the answer to your acne. Your acne are telling you that something in your body is not working in rhythm. The toxicity. What are acne? Acne are your toxins trying to come out from your body via these acne, via this pus. So what do we need to do? We need to make your body more alkaline. We need to remove all the toxicity from your body. We need to give the right nutrition to your body. And the minute you do all of that with your body, you will have zero acne, and that's something I can assure you. Yes, Akanksha, endometrium cancer, and that's one of the major things that PCOS leads to. And that's why we must nail this issue right now. We really ignore ourselves, we bloat, we have all the possible issues. We as women like to keep all of that within us, and then we think that now it's the time when it's above, you know, the water is above the head, then we decide ki ab main iska solution lungi, not the right way. Gayatri, skipping dinner is the worst thing you can do. But excellent, eating before 8 o'clock, it is a great sign. I don't know if you all have heard about digestive fire. You know, we all get our energy from where? Write it down. Where do we get our energy from? Where do plants get their energy from? Where do animals get their energy from? Okay. Where do plants get their energy? Sun. Excellent, Seema. Excellent. Excellent. So we must follow the sun. So the right time for your breakfast, the right time for your lunch, the right timing. It's not the diet, it's the timing which is very critical. So like you said, before 8 o'clock, there's a logic behind it. It is not ki jaldi kha lo to jaldi digest ho jayega. Of course it digests before you sleep, but 7 to 8 in the evening is the right time to have your meals. I mean, it's a 1 hour webinar in itself. I cannot talk in depth about it, but to answer your question, yes, before 8, 7 to 8 is the right time to eat. Sheetal, we need to understand why you are having bloating. So the couple of things that I can tell you to stop is definitely all the packaged foods, all the junk food that you're eating. You know, unfortunately, ladies, humne hamare Indian food ko bahut ignore kar diya. But it is so rich in nutrients. I will give you 3 fundas, Sheetal, what you should do. You should definitely eat local. You should definitely eat seasonal. And you should definitely, definitely eat organic. If you can make these 3 changes in your life, local, seasonal, and organic. Sheetal from NHRDN, you're here. Can we extend it for 5 minutes? There are a lot of questions. If you don't mind, can we extend it for 5-10 minutes more, this webinar? If you can give me a go ahead, because there are a lot of questions which are coming. So Shalaka, you don't need to include micronutrients from outside. You need to eat the right kind. So superfood, another thing that we ignore from our life. You'll get all your micronutrients if you have millets, which is called farmer's food, poor food, but it has so rich on micronutrients. How many of you all eat any millets? Jawar, bajra, kaun khata hai yahan pe? Nachni. So include millets in your food. Very good, Roshni. If you're eating jawar, bajra, which is excellent. Wow, Christina, great question. Again, something which will take an hour of discussing, but I'll make it very, very simple for you all. Non-veg. So first of all, we need to understand that the non-vegetarian food which is there today, it's all filled with toxicity. They are being given hormones to actually make their flesh thicker, to get more meat out of them. So just imagine they are being pumped with hormones, and then we eat that and we get that hormones in our body. So I'm not going to go in depth discussion about non-veg per se, but absolutely for PCOS condition, non-veg is a no. If you must eat, then take some gravy off it is what I'll say, but pieces must be avoided. If you can eliminate non-veg from your life, you will see an amazing difference in your acne, in your bloating, in your acidity, in your toxicity. That one thing can get so many things away from your life. Ragi, chickpeas, excellent. Shirisha, a must, go ahead. So not necessarily, Roshni, dandruff is not linked to PCOS. It's about the hygiene of your health and the condition of your health. But definitely hair fall is something which is connected to PCOS. So dandruff is not connected to PCOS. So Asta, first of all, you're doing a fantastic job. If you have, now that you realize that you have put on weight, first thing, stop blaming the workload. It's not the workload that has made you put on weight. It's the kind of food that you have eaten and is the kind of sedentary lifestyle. So I still believe that we women are really powerful to get a nice balance of work and ourselves. And this is an urge to all the women. All the women here, take out time for yourself. That 45 minutes in the morning, and be conscious about moving the whole day. So tomorrow when you wake up, just fold your bed sheet. That's a movement that you've done. Anytime you want to have water, don't keep a bottle water next to you. Just go and actually fill a glass of bottle and drink it. That's your movement. So consciously get movements in your life and you will see a difference in you. That's the feedback that I'll give you. Pooja, if you are planning to conceive, what I'll suggest, the first thing is, if you have PCOS, my suggestion to you is invest 3 to 4 months in reversing your PCOS and then plan. So if you waited this long, I would really urge you to give 3 months of your time to reversing PCOS. And we have an integrated solution. You can join our program or you can also try something else that you wish. But once you have actually reversed your PCOS, not only will you feel healthy, but the whole experience of motherhood will be amazing for you. You will not be going for injections. You will not be popping tablets. But you'll have an amazing 9 months to enjoy pregnancy. If you're wanting to conceive and enjoy pregnancy, please reverse your PCOS. And it's possible. That's what I'll tell you. Harpreet, so what you are doing is you're talking about food. Remember, we have 10 causes of PCOS. So great, you're not a non-veg lover. You hardly eat eggs. You take seasonal fruits. So you're taking care of your one pillar, which is eat. Now go back to all the 5 pillars and tell me what, think about it. How is your sleep pattern? How much stress do you take? What about your breathing? How are you ever spending time with your breath? What about your movement? So I want you to think about this. So this element of eat. So if you're doing all of this thing, great. You're taking care of one pillar. What about the rest? So Astra, is it? So the solution that we have created with our experts has no medicine in it. So I understand even if you're taking homeopathy, we are telling you reverse your PCOS without any medication. So I would strongly suggest that give this 3 months on reversal. You don't need the medicines. Medicines are all, you don't know what the medicine is doing in your body, right? So why take it? Absolutely, Ayushi. any of the symptoms like I spoke about, hirsutism, irregular periods, acne, difficulty in conceiving, mood swings, depression, all of this are symptoms. So you don't need to have all, but even if you have hirsutism, the chances of you having PCOS are higher. And absolutely not, Sarika. Sanitary pads have no impact on your periods. It's the quality of the pads, if you're getting rashes or if you're not comfortable with it, but it has nothing to do. Like, pads are not going to define whether you will get irregular periods or not. There is no connection. I'm sorry if I've skipped some answers, but my team is helping also in answering. So they are also answering all your questions. Rushikesh, my wife's question is, please suggest. So one, I am absolutely tell your wife there is no diet that she should follow. It's the right eating which she needs to focus on. And again, no medicine. So for hair fall, again, let me explain if your wife is listening. Why does hair fall happen? It's because of the hormonal imbalance. What do I mean by that? When you have more male hormones, androgens, they sit on the follicle of your hair and they are causing the hair fall. And for that, we need to have the right nutrients in our body. We need to, again, work on all the five pillars. I cannot prescribe any diet, and she should not take any medicine, because medicine is not going to do a deep root cause solution. Medicine will only do a superficial. So every time she'll stop the medicine, the hair will fall. Every time she'll eat the medicine, the hair will stay. That's not the kind of solution we want now, do we? I don't know your name, but it's possible to stop any medicine, provided we work on the five pillars, provided food is the best medicine, ladies. There is no better medicine than food. The minute you intake the right nutrients, you are there. Do you see any animal following a diet? The elephant knows what they need to eat. The lion knows what they need to eat, right or not? So why we as human beings need a diet? Why do we need someone to tell us when to eat and what to eat? I will tell you what are the right things, what food contains, what nutrients, and then you decide what options I have to get into my body. No problem, Rishikesh. Absolutely, Meetal, thyroid. So hypothalamus is the same gland which releases hormones which impact your thyroid, also PCOS. So there is a very deep link between PCOS and thyroid. The symptoms are also quite similar, and that's why when you reverse your PCOS, you reverse all the other things around it. Yes, absolutely, Kartika, I just spoke about it. Hyperthyroidism is a link. It's connected. So still science couldn't prove whether thyroid leads to PCOS or PCOS leads to thyroid. But yes, there is definitely a link, because hypothalamus gland is responsible to release hormones for both. See, again, Jigisha, there are so many people working on reversing diabetes also without medicine. So the point that I'm trying to make is, over a period of time, the ideal way for our body to function is on their own. There should not be any outside medicine trying to work on us. It will take its time, but it's possible. It's possible to be medicine free, and it should be that way. So Bina, rice is not as bad as sugar. Nothing is as bad as sugar. But there are five white poisons that we should avoid. Sugar for sure. All of you have committed to me that we will leave sugar. Then is salt. We need to be very careful of the kind of salt we are using. Then it's white flour, which is maida, which is again something that we must take care of. Rice. What kind of rice are we eating? Is it unpolished or polished? Very important. So unpolished rice, if eaten in the right quantity, again, mithara. We need to be sure that we are eating anything that we eat in moderation. If not, then it's a problem. All right, I know the questions are coming in, but it's 7:15, so I will pick up some more questions. But before that, I really, really want to thank NHRDN for giving this opportunity. Aman sir, I'm not sure if you're still here. Anand Khod sir, who's always been a strong pillar supporting. So Aman sir, Anand sir, Shilpa, Priya, for making this webinar possible, for making me reach out to these lovely ladies and always supporting folk fitness and our cause and being a very integral part of Freedom from PCOS. So I really want to thank all of you for supporting us. And for all of you who are still here, the 100 participants who are still here, if you want us to do this webinar for your corporate, we would love to host it. We have given you our numbers and the email ID. Githika can put that again. And please get in touch with us. If you want to reverse your PCOS, we have a program which is starting on 30th of August. I would love to have you with us on this journey of reversal, and we assure you, you will see results. Green coffee, that's interesting. I've never heard about it. Do you mean green tea? Because green coffee is something I'll have to research myself. I've not really heard about it. No problem, Astra. I hope. Thank you so much. Please do leave your feedback. Please give your feedback to NHRD and also whether this webinar was helpful or not. I don't mind being here for another 10 minutes and answering your questions, because there were so many questions and I want you all to take as much as possible. So Mrudil, alternative to salt is rock salt. Your sendha namak, sea salt. Change your table salt, which is, you know, jo aise haath se gir jata hai, very, very granular. It's not good for your health. So convert your salt into rock salt. No, Mrudil, there is no connection between water retention and PCOS as such. But yes, you're feeling bloated. We need to understand more what is the reason. Again, water, just because someone has told you ki 4 liters water should go in our body, we need to know how much water my body needs. So you should drink water as per your body communicates with you. And again, if you spend time alone with your body, if you're eating in silence, if you're drinking in silence, trust me, your body talks to you. You will know when to stop. So another thing that you must do is stop your TV, keep your gadgets away, have family meals time. Whenever you're eating, eat in silence. Silence is very, very, very powerful. So I want all of you to take that time and definitely work on it. Raut, I will definitely research. I honestly, I don't know about green coffee, but that's something interesting. I haven't heard about it, so I really cannot comment about it. But I'll definitely, this is something that I would love to research with my team. So PCOS and menopause, interesting. So first thing that happens is your menopause years become, like, you get menopause much early. Like, women today are getting menopause at the age of 40-42, which is not the right age. Also, the pain that you go through menopause if you have PCOS is huge. Again, in PCOS, if you're getting missed periods, irregular periods, you're already prone to a lot of symptoms and disorders in your body. And that's why the earlier you reverse your PCOS, the smoother your menopause will be, and the reactions that your body will go through will be much easier. So let me tell you, green tea, green coffee are not going, if you drink 5 cups of green tea or for that matter green coffee, you're not going to reduce weight. Green tea is filled with antioxidants, so it's a great thing to have as a replacement to your tea and coffee. That also caffeine free. So your body needs to be caffeine free, for which if there's an alternative, it's great. So green tea definitely has great benefits. But if you're assuming that I will not move and by having green tea, I'm going to reduce weight, it's not going to happen. So that we must be clear about. Great question, Lakshmi, and my team has answered it. But yes, we cannot say if PCOS caused depression or depression caused PCOS. But there is a very deep link, because it's a psychosomatic disorder, which means your mind and your body both have to be worked on. And so the answer is there. You can read about it. Sorry, I didn't understand, Sumitha. Skipping what is beneficial? If you can write the whole question, I didn't understand that. Skipping what is beneficial? No problem, Lakshmi. I hope you got your answer. Is skipping okay? Skipping the exercise beneficial? Of course. So skipping is cardiovascular. Can only skipping help you to reverse PCOS? No. Is skipping a good add-on for reversal? Absolutely yes. A great question, Seema. Which oil to use? First of all, anyone who told you zero ghee, zero oil, we need good fats. We also need fats. So you must use oil in moderation. Remember the word mitahara. Whatever goes in your body should go in moderation. You need to use oil as per the region where you stay and as per the season. Okay. If you visit our YouTube channel, if you go to our website, we have a lot of detailed things about it. But it has to be as per the region and as per the season. If it's too cold a season, then there are specific oils that you should use. If it's hotter season, then you should not use particular oils. There is a whole thing about oil, which we cannot discuss in the limited time. But you should not use only one oil. Especially people say olive oil. Olive oil is not something which is local and seasonal. So no, but groundnut oil, coconut oil, and you can keep sesame oil, and you can keep changing it as per the season. I hope I answer that. Okay. Are we good to go? I hope you got our YouTube channel link. I hope you got our email ID. Absolutely not, Seema. With microwave, all you will do is say 5 minutes. What do you use microwave for? Reheating your food. What is the container that you use? So you're killing all the nutrients of your food and you're putting all the toxicity through the radiation. So microwave is a no-no. It's something from your house which must be eliminated. Roshni, there is not a specific must-have. Local, seasonal, organic, millets. Rich food, good food at the right time is something which will help you in your PCOS condition. But there is no specific must-haves. No microwave, but glass is a great, you can use glass. Glass doesn't leach. So glass is great for serving and storing your food, but no microwave. Okay, someone has to tell me if I have to stop, because I'll keep going on. I have these lovely ladies asking me questions, and I think I'll just continue. Age is just a number. So it depends on, I am 38 and I do weight training. I do folk fitness. I do yoga. It depends on what you've been doing so far. And then you have to include exercises. So what we do is we do lesser intensity first and then go on higher intensity. But walking can be an add-on, but it cannot be just an exercise. And you're just 45. So That's a very, very young age for us. So Bushra, the first thing is you should not sleep late, but if you have to make the first change in your sleep. So the ideal is, again, remember sun, we should follow the sun. So when the sun goes down, we should be in our bed. So 9:30, 10 is a great time to sleep. But if you have working hours and if you're watching Netflix, Amazon and sleeping late, But if you're working and it's something that you have to do, then at least calendarize that sleep hour. So if you're sleeping at 11 or 11:30, then make sure that you're not sleeping at 1 day, 2 o'clock one day. Sleep every day at 11, 11:30. And you will start seeing the change. And it's also not the quantity, it's the quality. So are you getting quality sleep? That's very important. A great question, Jonita. In fact, I must tell you a story. In our current batch, one of our ladies had severe migraine issue. And so we start with detox for a week. And you won't believe, so she had this migraine tablet in her jeans pocket, in her purse, everywhere. And you will relate to it, right? Because someone who has migraine is always carrying those tablets. I had insisted her not to take tablet. She had 2 days of severe headache, migraine. She puked. But if you ask her today, and I have a testimonial and I would love to share with you all, she is absolutely migraine free and she has no tablets around her and she feels so empowered because something that she's been carrying for 20 years has just left her. So with this 5 pillars and with this 3 months program, you see your migraine reversing within 2 to 3 weeks itself. So absolutely, migraine is something that you can absolutely reverse. On that note, lovely ladies, I will be ending the webinar now. Thank you so much for being a part of this. Thank you, NHRDN, for giving me this opportunity. If you all want me to be a part of your corporate, I would love to. If you all want to be a part of our program, you have the details, reach out to us, and we would love to be a part of your reversal journey. Thank you so much. I hope this webinar was fruitful for you all. Thank you. Thank you so much. Take care. Good night. Bye.